Good eye. It's Ben from Oz, the shaman from Oz. Organic portal signs. Signs you're dealing with an OP. A spiritless human, soulless human, who, well, you know, they have a group soul, 2D, second dimension. Listen, this video, I want to be completely different to my organic portal definition video, defining what is a organic portal. That video tries to, I guess, make a template for, you know, really a pretty reasonable outline for what an organic portal is. In this video, I kind of want to color in the outline a bit. So I want to color in the, in between the lines, so to speak, that I created. So that video I explained to you, like, how they're, you know, and here's a good example of how that was more of a template video, the organic portal definition video. I said, you know, organic portals are only active in the bottom chakras, and hence, and why they're only active in the bottom chakras is because it's the bottom triangle of the Merkaba, the light body vehicle. And it's the bottom triangle, but there is an upper triangle, and that's associated to the upper chakras that they're missing. So that triangle for them does not spin clockwise, and energy does not go up for them. Hence, why they're always so negative, because energy is spinning down for them anti-clockwise in the bottom rotating field of the Merkaba, which is counter-rotative. So when you do, if you watch my meditation video, Four Best Eclectic Meditation video, you'll see the Villa Doctor go into the Google Tech Talks video. It's called How to Heal Psychosomatic Disorders with Meditation. And Dr. Villy shows you some great techniques for Kundalini. Now, I'm not huge on Kundalini because it's one of the lower energies. Right now, I'm starting to get more into prana. Not that I always haven't been or anything, but it seems different years I focus on different techniques. Like the other year, I was really into the chi stuff and Muntak Chia's microcosmic orbit from the Taoists that he showed us. But there's a really good Kundalini technique, and at the top of your head, you say Mother, like Mother Kundalini, you know, and that's why I know it's like lower nature energy as well. Mother Kundalini, or you can just say Mother, or you can just, yeah, well, you don't really say Kundalini, you say Mother or Mother Kundalini, it feels better. And you rotate your hand on the top of your head. I actually showed you this in the first video in the $30 Bandit Food Plant Teaching series playlist on my channel is for Cheryl Thomas and antioxidation. And this Kundalini technique's antioxidation or antioxidative. And so I put it in that video, and you see me there doing it, sitting on the grass. I rotate my hand clockwise on the top of my head, my right hand, can be your left hand too, depends which channel, the Ida or Pingala on the side of your spine that you're working, the energy channel. But yeah, you basically, you put your hand on top of your head, you pull in energy from the other hand, and then, you know, it goes through to the top of your head where your hand is on the top of your head from the other hand, and you feel the clearing of your nervous ganglii, the middle nervous system basically. And this is a really good technique, and one of the best I can think of for raising your energy and spinning it up. So you're spiraling up, not spinning down, okay? And you notice when you're in a negative spin, you're in a spin, yeah? Sometimes you can start out your day bad, and then you realize you're negatively spinning. The more conscious you are, the quicker you sort of get out of that, is what I've noticed over the years with myself. But I remember, you know, you get into a negative spin, right? get into it. Once you get negative, you sometimes can very easily get into a negative tailspin, like an airplane diving. So they're like that a lot. Now, this little list here I'm putting off is not necessarily, if someone is negative, they are an organic portal. That's not what this little list is saying. And this is off the top of my head, this little list. So maybe I'll make another video called Organic Portal Signs 2. Signs you're dealing with an organic portal number 2. But anyway, let's get into it. So negative, you know, they're always fairly negative. Now, not in general. They're, like I've said before, organic portals are often quite inert and there is an activation aspect to them. However, I do still feel that inherently psychopathic and fairly inherently negative because of what I just mentioned. It's because of their own dynamics, not because I will it to be. You know, not because I wish for it, but it's because they're in the lower Merkaba, which spins only down. And that's why henceforth. Yeah? Alright. So, negativity. And it's like negative on what you say, because through the organic portal, you're talking to the hive mind of the matrix, really. And that's why they're negative, to piss you off. That's why they're not just always negative, necessarily. It is a common trait, but yeah, they do it to really tick you off. You know, that's one thing that the hive mind seems to love to do to me, just to annoy me. Not just for distraction or forward momentum so it can keep its reign of terror, so to speak, and its control, but, you know, just it seems to, not even just to distract me, but just to annoy me, to take me out. So yes, for the same end reason of keeping its reign of terror, but, you know, different methodology. It can annoy, distract, or just distract, you know what I'm saying. So what else? Organic portal. Well, they're dense. They're made out of denser stuff than us. So density. Just dense thoughts, dense attachments, yeah? Attachment to too much makeup. Could be one for a girl. Just think about these little points, okay? And you make your own little list. Otherwise, we'll be here all day. No, but, okay, so density, you know, they think everything is what it seems to be, like they think physicality is all there is. Okay, so along the lines of density is another point of discernment of how to tell an organic portal. Another organic portal sign. Let's see, density, negativity. Yeah, materialism, you just gotta say materialism sometimes. Sometimes there's no better word. So materialism. They're very materialistic, right? To the point of YOLO. YOLO, you only live once. It's YOLO, YOLO, you only live once. Because they do only live once. It's the souled human and the self-spirited human who seems to, you know, keep carnating or reincarnating for experience or whatever have you. So yeah, YOLO is really an organic portal aspect, I find. It's the people like Don Juan. Remember Don Juan, the Mexican shaman from Carlos Castaneda readings? He said, "The difference between me and you, Carlos," Don said to him, "is you think you have all the time in the world. I think I have no time." And that's what I realized why I do all this. Because I realized my impending death. Now, the organic portal type people or societals of the YOLO nature, well, that's why they're so obsessed with control this life. I've got to get a lot of money. I've got to be the CEO. You know what I mean? That's why they go that crazy career path, that boring life of the career path, get married, obey, conform, and die. Because, you know, to them, there's not necessarily an afterlife, it's only a belief to them. Oh yeah, I believe in God. Yeah, I'm going to heaven, worship Jesus, blah blah blah. But that's not real. It's something they believe and tell themselves. Like we originally realized that organic portals believe themselves to be alive, like Gurdjieff always used to say. And it's really this YOLO aspect I see being an organic portal sort of life frame, like I've just mentioned, how they go about their life, you know. So that's another thing, the YOLO and the materialism, and they connect. Obviously, all these fairly much connect. But yeah, those two really connect as well, or more than the density and the negativity stuff, even maybe. Well, no, because in the lower chakras, you're more dense. So yeah, those connect too. Anyway, let's keep going. So yeah, materialism, you know, they think that the material universe is all there is. There is no higher light, there is no dimensions, and so on for these organic portal spiritless humans. Because they are spiritless, it's your higher spirit who experiences the higher dimensionality. People like the Buddhists, they call that the id, and that's why I say indigos are in the idgos. Indigo. You've heard of these indigo people, indigo children? Well, hello. I'm like indigo king over here. The way I approach life is super indigo, anyway. You know, they are out to go. There's another point. Out to goes. I did make a video on that. Indigos and out to goes. Organic portals are out to goes. Their focus is outward. There's something a friend of mine said to me long ago. He said, inward, onward, and upward. And I went, ah, great little phrase. Inward, onward, and upward. Indeed, my friend, indeed. So, they are not like that. There is no inward, there is no onward and upward. They're very stagnative beings in their mind, I mean, mentally. And there's no inner essence, right? That's the whole thing about this. You know, that's like one of the main themes or aspects of an organic portal, right? So I don't have to harp on about that because everybody's talking about it. But yeah, their focus is outward and into this world, into the lower third dimension, yeah? So that's their focus. That's another way you can tell and another way to discern how to tell who is an organic portal. Are they very out to go? Now, let's connect back to the materialism and the out to go. They make very good scientists for this reason, because you know, science is only looking at the material, mostly. Mostly, yes. I've heard of quantum physics, don't worry. I studied it years ago, in depth, years and years ago. And, you know, that to them is still fairly materialistic, I've got to say. And it's why they often come up with the stupidest ever conclusions in their little science articles. But, you know, they make really good scientists because most of science is, you know, focusing very materially. I know there's a lot of, you know, like I mentioned, quantum physics experiments and so on going on these days, and that's not really the scientists that I'm talking about. Those guys are more often spirited humans because they are very interested in the non-material workings and what the hell is going on here. Things do not appear to be as they appear. You know, they're spirited humans, but I just wanted to say that because, you know, some people might think that organic portals are just dumb people or something, but no, they can be, you know, smart people, but not intelligent, not intel agents. Intelligence. They're not intel agents. They don't have the real intel, no gnosis, no real knowing. And they can't see into things. They see the object, but they do not see inside the object or why the object exists or how the object is and so on. So that's the organic portal, okay? So I wasn't just saying all scientists are organic portals. That would be stupid to say.